sure whether I'm going to be as informative and entertaining as the last presentation. I'm talking about search engines. My name is John Bolakis. I'm one of the, I guess you could say, founders of search engine optimization in Australia. We went and registered SEO.com.au back in 1999, before Google's even around, knowing very well that whilst the dot-com madness was looming ahead, that the only real way a website could really make it on the web was to get lots of traffic. And apart from lots of affiliate models that exist now, back then, and even those affiliate models that exist now, they all depend on search and mainly on Google and Google traffic. Today I've been asked to talk about one particular aspect of search engines, which is effective link building strategies. Definitely when it comes to search, there's lots of different aspects in terms of how do I get my website to the top of Google, and how do I therefore maximize my traffic from end users using the likes of Google. So how to get linked up for search engines. Both Google, Yahoo and 90% offer some information about links. Now these slides, I believe, will be a whole section there that talks about links. Feel free to read. Links that occur naturally. If you try to link your website up very quickly, they'll catch on to that. If you're advertising on people's sites where there's a section called link partners or text to that effect, they'll catch on to that and they won't allow your website to benefit from such links. Something that not too many people are familiar with or know about, but now you all know. So when it comes to link building, I could show you lots of diagrams and I could talk about Google's patent on link building, but when it comes to links, really, whoever has the most number of contacts, they're going to be the main person or persons who are going to stand out in the crowd. So websites are much the same. It's very much like almost pyramid building. So the person up the top gets to enjoy the highest rankings and therefore the most traffic, and then it flows down. When you're doing link building, you need to choose your keywords carefully. So whilst I could have 50 websites linking to me, all with the text online gaming, that's one approach, but ideally you want to have different websites using different text linking back to you. You need to know what those keywords are so that you can maximize your rankings for these keywords and therefore get maximum traffic to your website. People often refer to keywords as the short main keywords that people look for, or the long tail string keywords. So for example, online gaming versus I'm looking for a online gaming. Another way of generating links is by, of course, building multiple websites that you in turn own. You can populate these websites with lots of content and have them linking back to you. So that's another sort of easier way, or a way that you can control what websites link back to you. And of course, the final point I've made there is persist, persist, persist. You need to constantly be on top of links. You need to be constantly asking for other website owners to link back to you, exchanging links. Links is one of these sort of never-ending jobs that we do in search engine optimization. Blog sites and Facebook websites to rank much better. If you own, or if you have friends that own a Facebook site, getting a link from there, be it their personal page or their business page, will help your website rankings. Of course, there are plugins. Some of these allow you to add eBay ads, Google AdSense ads. But ultimately, these sort of sites are what you want to build and generate and get other people out there using, populating it with content, and then linking back from these websites to your site. Google takes particular notice of all social marketing type websites. Initially, when they first sort of came out for the first couple of years, these sort of websites Google regards as news sites. So any news Google finds on the web, which is fresh content, Google rank very quickly. So if you're getting links from these types of websites, you're well on your way to achieving higher rankings. And of course, if...
Yeah, so tell us who you are, where you're from, and what's it like?
My name's Scott Logan. I'm with BingoPort.co.uk. We run bingo sites in the UK, mainly UK market. But we are based here in Australia, so to come to an event like this has been great to see people in our industry. We also do some Australian sports stuff, so that helps us as well because there's a lot of sports books here and we're finding it very valuable.
And what's the feeling amongst the people here in terms of Australia?
Well, there's still a bit of confusion around Australia as a market for online gaming, but we're finding that it's becoming a lot clearer as time goes on, and especially with the wagering side of things, that is very clear, and there's a lot of activity in that market, and we're finding that there's a lot of activity as an affiliate. There's a lot more of an understanding of what we do, our business model, and the way that they can help us going forward. So we're finding a lot of value in talking to the operators and getting better deals at a conference like this.
And lastly, the sessions here, the kinds of topics. I mean, what are probably the most important topics in your mind for people to get under their belt?
Things like search engine optimization. The legal session was very interesting. Just what other operators and affiliates have planned in the future and how we can take advantage of that. So we're finding, and also I think the booths and having the operators here that you can actually go and talk to them, do better deals and things like that, it's really making a big difference.
Perfect.
All right.